General considerations in meter safety. The circuit board is powered with 12 volt DC. A transformer is used to provide this power. It is unlikely that harmful current will be present. Circuit measurements with a multi-tester usually occur with power applied to the circuit. These measurements usually are made because something has happened to cause a circuit or a device or a piece of equipment to operate improperly. Measurements are being made to locate the problem. This is called troubleshooting the circuit. Because power is applied, special safety precautions should be observed. Make certain that measurement terminals are not shorted together or to ground by the test leads. This is especially so when 110 VAC line voltage is being measured. Severe shock or extensive damage can result if caution is not exercised. The selector dials must also be set to the correct position when using the meter. V is for voltage. The omega or ohms sign is for resistance. A is for amperage. And MA is for milliamps. Voltage drop can be used to spot bad connections and defective components. To check voltage drop across a component, place the red lead on the positive side and the black lead on the negative side as close as possible to the component being measured. The circuits on rungs 2 and 3 are designed to demonstrate a defective circuit which can be detected with voltage drop. Rung 2 provides two circuits to operate the motor. The upper circuit has a 2 ohm resistor in the circuit which would cause a small voltage drop, leaving less force at the motor. By setting the meter to read DC voltage, place the red lead on the positive side of the motor at TP3. Place the black lead on TP2. Close S1, S2, and S3 and record the voltage. With S1, S2, and S3 closed, and with R1 resistor in the circuit, one would expect a voltage drop across the resistor, lowering the voltage available to run the motor. Checking amperage requires the amp meter be placed into the circuit so that the current flows through it. The only way to do this with the circuit board is to bridge a switch with the meter. Always measure with S1 in the closed position. Always place the red lead of the amp meter on TP1. Always leave the first switch open on the rung of the circuit being tested. Always place the black lead on the first test point after the open switch. Never place the black lead on the negative or ground side of the circuit, as this will blow the fuse. Ensure that the meter is configured to measure maximum amperage. By bridging S2 and closing S3 with the red lead on TP1 and the black lead on TP4, the motor will be energized. Plug the red lead into the volt omega milliamp port of the meter. Set the meter to read mid-range of the ohm scale. Make sure the power source is turned off and that all switches are open, that is, turned off. Checking the schematic, the test points on either side of R9 are TP12 and TP13. Applying the red lead to TP12, and the black lead to TP13 reads approximately 745 ohms.